And over in Negros Occidental, confirmed cholera cases have now risen to 26. Local health officials believe the outbreak could be due to poor sanitation. For more on this, we are joined by Dr. Ernel Tumimbang, Negros Occidental's Provincial Health Officer. Good morning, Dr. Tumimbang. Thank you for joining us.
Good morning, Mike. Yes. Morning.
All right. Doctor, can you first give us an update on these confirmed cholera cases as well as lives lost to it in Negros Occidental? How are the patients who have contracted cholera currently handling?
Yes, Nikki, we have right now 28 cases of cholera in Negros Occidental. We have two deaths from that 28 cases. All those cases, excluding the deaths, are all recovering in the hospital where they are admitted at the provincial Tresita Randone Provincial Hospital in Silay. So they are doing well. The two deaths were due to, of course, the severe dehydration that they have. One is an elderly and one is at a younger age. So high risk na mag-grupo natin, Nikki.
Mm-hmm. And following this, how are you strengthening your monitoring of supplies, utilities, especially bringing local water sources natin, no, to the LGUs affected?
Yes. Suggest
that they do that?
Yes. The governor has issued an executive order to that effect for purposes of monitoring all water sources, particularly even concentrating to those refilling stations and other sources, most especially from the area where clustering of cases are. We are monitoring and treating right away any water resources that we identify that might be high risk in inducing diarrheal diseases. So right now, yes, Aniki, yes.
Doctor, ano po bang mga areas to yung most affected? Yung naka-cluster po yung cases.
Talisay is one, most especially in the areas of Dos Hermanas. Silay has 8 cases, Enrique Magalona has 6, and Victoria has 1. All these are concentrated in the 3rd District of Negros Occidental. Mm-hmm. So doon ang concentration natin, Nikki, no? We are monitoring cases and we are sending those identified water sources at the RITM for purposes of identifying if there are cholera bacteria in those water sources. Right now, we have identified all these 28 cases where they are getting their water supply. And so far, the RITM has identified one positive for cholera in EB Magalona. But all these patients, Nikki, are positive in cholera on laboratory examinations at the hospital. So we are now getting results from the RITM. So far, we have just one positive cases of cholera from the water sources that we have.
Mm-hmm. And Dr. Tumimbang, how does the recent onslaught of severe tropical storm Paeng in your area impact your efforts to fight cholera?
Well, so far, this has really affected the water supply. That's why we have an increases of acute diarrheal disease, not only on cholera, but typhoid as well. Another acute diarrheal disease, like, for example, E. coli. So this has really brought up monitoring at its highest level. We are now getting more acute diarrheal disease, but we are right now addressing this through a proper sanitation protocol. And one, For the long term solution for this is we are now supporting, and for the longer time, the Negros Occidental is doing this, the zero opidification. That means we are now addressing those areas with low number of toilets, because the usual route of transmission of acute diarrheal disease is by fecal oral route. Mm-hmm. And if you have problem with water and sanitation and hygiene,
right,
definitely this will cause a long-term problem in addressing any acute diarrheal disease. These are the long-term solutions that we are focusing, and we are doing that right now. And we are, again, updating the governor for whatever executive order throughout the province of Negros Occidental. to really implement whatever executive order that we have.
And Dr. Dumimbang, are you also in constant communication with the DOH, other concerned government agencies, as well as NGOs who may be able to help?
Yes, we do. We do report to the regional health office. We send report likewise to the national government. And we are again monitoring all those areas with positive cases, and we inform the LGUs that they have increasing they have a rise in cholera cases or even acute diarrheal disease, not necessarily cholera. And we are again giving technical assistance. We do support them with logistics, giving IV fluids, and of course other medicines for that matter, to address any increases and rise, and assist them in sanitation protocol in the area of concern.
Mm-hmm. And Dr. Dumimbang, we know cholera can be prevented via vaccines, right? How goes our supply of cholera vaccines? Do you think it's possible to procure more?
Right now, we are very dependent with regards to the vaccine from the department. Mm-hmm. There's none really cholera vaccine coming from the DOH. And mm-hmm. if there is an oral vaccine for cholera. Mm-hmm. It's very expensive, I think. But I think the solutions that I would suggest is really doing the preventive measures of water sanitation and hygiene, most especially the zero open defecation. That means toilet for every family in every area in the barangay in Negros Occidental.
It's good to know that we're not there yet, but we can focus on the more preventive measures first. All right, on that note, thank you so much for joining us this morning, Dr. Dumimbang, and stay safe.
Thank you, Nikki. Thank you, Mike. Thank you for the invites. Stay safe.